recommendation 4 of the What Works Clearinghouse Practice Guide, Assisting Students Struggling with Mathematics, Intervention in the Elementary Grades, is about using the number line to facilitate the learning of mathematical concepts and procedures, to build an understanding of grade level material, and to prepare students for advanced mathematics. The WWC and expert panel assigned a strong level of evidence to this recommendation, meaning that there is consistent evidence that meets WWC standards and indicates that the practice improves outcomes for diverse student populations. The number line is a unique mathematical representation that can represent all real numbers, including whole numbers and rational numbers, as well as positive and negative numbers. The number line's ability to represent different sets of numbers makes it a powerful tool for helping students develop a unified understanding of numbers and for supporting their learning of advanced mathematics. This recommendation explains methods for using the number line to teach and support critical understanding of mathematics during intervention. Each step provides guidance for whole numbers in early elementary grades, K through 2, and fractions and decimals in upper elementary grades, 3 through 6. The first step to carry out this recommendation is to represent whole numbers, fractions, and decimals on a number line to build students' understanding of numerical magnitude. Number lines can be used to show the pattern of unit fractions and their corresponding magnitude. A number line that goes from 0 to 1 can be partitioned into different sized parts to help students see the relative magnitude of each fraction. For representing fractions and whole numbers concurrently, number lines help students see that whole numbers can be represented as fractions and that similar fractions are located between whole numbers on the number line. Number lines can demonstrate the magnitude of fractions greater than 1 or less than 1. Additionally, fractions that are equivalent occupy the same place on the number line. Using number lines to demonstrate number relationships and equivalencies is powerful and necessary to build students' number sense. For students who don't seem to have a good grasp of the number line and what it represents, concrete representations help transition students towards understanding the number line. Fraction tiles or Cuisenaire rods can be linked to number lines, for example, because they both use length as the attribute to represent numerical relationships. A second action step is to use number lines as a tool to compare numbers and determine relative size and help students understand magnitude and quantity. For positive whole numbers, teachers should use the number line for students to see the distance from 0 a number occupies. The further to the right, the larger the number. Having students think about benchmark numbers like 0, 1/2, and 1 is one way to help students reason about fraction magnitudes. Teachers can help students think about unit fractions being closer to 0, or if a fraction is close to a fraction equivalent to 1 or 1/2 when estimating placement on the number line. The third action step is to use number lines to build students' understanding of the concepts underlying operations. For whole numbers, students can see addition and subtraction by moving distance on a number line. The same approach also works when adding fractions. Fractions may introduce additional complexity when two add ends don't have the same denominator. When this happens, number lines are a powerful visual that is useful for finding an equivalent fraction so that students can successfully solve the problem. Number lines are important because they are a mathematically accurate representation of math and are used across advanced mathematics.